We're here at Cliff Cave in St. Louis County, and this is a new cave gate that we have built for the protection of endangered Indiana bats. And we discovered these bats in here with the St. Louis County Parks Division just last year. And that is a severely endangered bat, so we were able to get funding to protect these bats with an angle iron cave gate, which keeps intruders out, keeps people from disturbing them during the sensitive time that they are here. It took us about a week to build this large gate. It's 17 feet high and about 47 feet wide, weighs several tons. The horizontal bars are spaced just right to allow bats to fly through while not admitting most adult people. We fully expect to see an increase in bats in the next couple of years. We probably have about 125 known cave gates in Missouri, that is on all different landowners. Out of 6,300 caves, it's only about 2% of the known caves that are gated. So we're certainly not trying to gate all the caves of Missouri. It's really only the most important ones usually that have endangered bats or other endangered species. And then two, we have sometimes gated caves that were being abused by rampant vandalism. Cave gates have benefits beyond just the endangered bats that usually are the impetus for funding the cave gate. Multiple natural resources and cultural resources are often protected. We often see an increase in amphibians, you know, salamanders, cave salamanders, long-tailed salamanders, and other types of animals in the cave. And just common bats like the pipistrelle and big brown bats, little brown bats, they're also known from here. Sometimes when we have a large maternity colony of gray bats, we'll have other style of cave gates so they can fly over an opening above the gate and don't have a traffic jam piling up at the entrance, which actually would discourage them and maybe make them abandon the cave. We have chute gates, we have window gates, we have cupola gates. So we have different styles for different situations.